Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica, and today I'm doing a first impression and some looks, not some looks, a look, with swatches of the new Colourpop Just My Luck palette just in time for St. Patrick's Day. This palette like literally got sneak peeked, revealed, and dropped within like one morning from Colourpop, and I was kind of surprised. I feel like this is something I really don't know. Is this like a new thing where I kind of prefer it almost because I don't like it when like releases get drawn out to a point where you're like, okay, let me just see what it looks like. But also I feel like it's another thing to like, again, sneak peek release drop within the span of like 2 hours. But I saw this all on Twitter when I was at work, and then it dropped when I was on my lunch break, so I purchased it right there, and I got it within the week. I really hope and I believe this is a permanent palette from their website, so let me just pull that up real quick. I'm not prepared. Okay, so this was $12. Of course, I had to pay shipping because I didn't hit the $30 mark to get shipping because I wanted just to buy this right away. So I just got this and I paid like $5 or $6 for shipping. So it ended up being just under $20. According to the website, we know you've been waiting for this baby. Meet the newest sis to your monochromatic palette fam. She's so lucky, you'll know she'll be the star of your makeup collection. With 9 richly pigmented shadows and every shade of green you can think of. I can think of a few more. It's easy to create the perfect monochromatic look. Get fun, get creative, bold looks. I can't read. Got fun, creative, bold looks up your sleeve? We're totally here for it. And they list all of the shades. So this is actually the first type of palette in this packaging that I've purchased. I believe they have quite a few. And like they said, it's like a monochromatic family. So I know they had a purple one. It would help if I actually looked up what they have. Okay, so looking at their website, it looks like the original palettes to come out in this packaging were the Sol and the Mar palettes, which I'm pretty sure I mentioned in a past weekly wow, but they weren't different enough to get me interested, but they were the first to appear in this like new plastic packaging. After that one, we got the Ooh La La and the It's My Pleasure palettes. If I remember correctly, the Ooh La La, that pink one, released like right by Mean Girls Day, October 3rd. And then the It's My Pleasure came out probably not too long before or after that. And then this is the next in the series, the green one. Right now, all the other palettes, I guess there's a sale right now on the Colourpop website, like site-wide. And since this is brand new along with their new spring line, it's not included in the sale. But right now, the rest of those palettes are on sale for under $10. So that being said, these pan sizes are the same pan size that you would see in any other Colourpop palette. They're smaller than their single shadows, but you still get a lot of actual product in here. I don't see the grams listed anywhere on the website. Let me look. I saw the carton. Let's see. Okay, so it's 0.04 ounces of product in the entire palette. I don't want to do math. So overall, you get like 1.2 grams of product in here. And that's if Google isn't lying to me. So I gotta say, I actually really like this packaging. I really think it is a step up from the previous packaging, which really, it was just a way to get their shadows into a palette format for the first time. This feels really nice. Like, I feel like looking at this and feeling it, I feel like it's worth way more than $12. So you've got the plastic packaging. It's got a really nice closure on it. It feels very secure. I really like that they have a sticker on the back with all of the shade names, and the design is just so cute. My favorite part, aside from the actual shadows, is how huge this mirror is. Not to blind you, but it's gigantic. And this, I want to take this traveling because I don't know if you can tell, I mentioned this before, but the way that you can actually position the mirror and it stays there. There's a lot of palettes I have where it'll open up to like just here. And like if I'm setting this up on like a vanity and it only opens up to here, how am I gonna do my makeup? If I'm in a hotel room trying to do my makeup or whatever, I want to be able to adjust this and have my hands free to do whatever I need to do. And I really like that. So gigantic mirror, it does go all the way back and it's just secure. I love this. God, this is part of what makes it feel so nice to me. And then you actually have your shades. So I've only dipped into one of these shades because I really couldn't help myself. So let's just do some quick swatches on my arm. Let me scoot. I haven't tried to do like live swatches. So let's see. One, 1, 2, 3. So that is the top row, the first row right here. And in order, these are the shade Chances Are, Kiss My Ass, and So So. Ooh. Ooh. So this is the second row. The shades in order, once again, are Big Banks, Mary Jane. That's actually a shade that's really reminding me of that shade from their Good Sport palette that I really like. Looks very similar. And All of You. I don't know what to do with this hand. Do I like go, or do I go like, All right, and our last row, those are gorgeous. Oh. Our last row, shades in order are Act Natural, Mobamba, and Charmed. So since I've been rambling for a bit through this video already, I'm gonna do my one look a bit sped up in the typical way I do my tutorials, and I'm gonna see how many shades I can use from the palette. Guys, so this is the final look that I ended up with, and I have to say, I'm beyond impressed. I tried to use as many shades as I could, ended up using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 out of the 9, and I do like the shades. The only thing, I kind of wish this first light green shade was just a little bit more pigmented. It wasn't enough to use just that as a transition shade. It's more of like a highlight, like a brow bone kind of highlight shade, or something you would put down like as a base and not like an actual pigmented transition shade. But I was very impressed by the deeper green matte down here in the corner, the shade Act Natural. That was very pretty. And I do love the Mary Jane shade that I have all over my lids. Overall, first impression, awesome palette. I cannot wait to play more with this palette in the future. I don't know if I would be doing like a 3 looks 1 palette. I could definitely try if you guys want to see that, because I also noticed as I was playing with it that if you take these into like little trios, you basically have like a look right here, a look right here, and this is a shimmer. But if you wanted to make a more dramatic look, you might be able to do that trio as a look as well. But let me know what else you guys want to see with this palette. And if you did miss one of my previous videos, I did do a big swatch party of all of my green shadows. So if this one's not right up your alley, but you still want to look at some green shadows, go check that video out. So thank you guys for watching. I hope if you like this video, you give it a thumbs up. Let me know down below what else you want to see with this palette. Can I speak with this palette or with green shadows in the future? And I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Bye.